So let's work over the closing entries review. So when we're dealing with closing entries, we need to think about which accounts are temporary accounts and which accounts are permanent accounts. So an account's either going to be temporary or permanent. So first, the temporary accounts. Those are going to be your revenue accounts, right? So service revenue, sales revenue, subscription revenue, any kind of revenue accounts that a company has. Any expense accounts will also be temporary. And then your owner's drawings account will be temporary. Meaning your permanent accounts will be things like your assets, so cash, accounts receivable, supplies, equipment. All of those asset accounts are permanent. Liability accounts are permanent. And owner's capital is permanent. Now, what does this mean? Well, some of these accounts are closed and some are never closed. So your temporary accounts are the accounts that get closed. What we are trying to do whenever we close an account is we just want to make these account balances down to zero. So if we still owe salaries, that's going to pop up later on in a payable account. So that's still going to be owed. But we want to make our expenses and our revenues and our drawings zero balances at the end of these closing entries. So there's a process that we're going to get into with these closing entries. There's four closing entries that we make. And they're going to be in the same order every time. So the first step is to close all of your revenue accounts to this new account that pops up called Income Summary. So Income Summary is this account that appears during the closing process. It shows up in the closing process and then it's closed shortly thereafter. So we close our revenues to an account called Income Summary. And then we close our expenses to income summary. So those will be the first two closing entries in our process here. Then we're going to have a balance in income summary based off of those first two closing entries. And that balance in income summary means that we will then need to close income summary to owner's capital. Now, you'll also see this be called closing your net income or net loss to owner's capital because your balance in income summary after the first two closing entries will be your net income or your net loss. Then, after we close our income summary, we close owner's drawings to owner's capital. So what we're doing here is we are putting in journal entry form the pieces of the owner's equity statement. Right? We show how net income or net loss affects owner's capital, and we show how owner's drawings affects owner's capital. So that's what we're doing here with these closing entries. And now you'll notice your revenues, expenses, income summary, and owner's drawings are the four accounts that are closed. Owner's capital is involved, but owner's capital is a permanent account, so things are closed to owner's capital, but owner's capital itself is never closed. So now we have this example. So we have some account balances there in the upper left. We have a $40,000 balance to owner's capital, $15,000 for drawings, $120,000 for revenue, and then we have our four different expense accounts: advertising, utilities, salaries, and rent. So we need to take those and figure out what the closing entries would be. And if we think back to the that flow chart that we just looked at, right, our first closing entry will be to close our revenues to income summary. So what we are looking at here is just the line that says service revenue. That's the only information that we need for this closing entry. And we think about service revenue as an account. Service revenue has a normal credit balance, which means to zero out our service revenue, we're going to need to debit our revenue, right? We're going to do the opposite of the normal balance here in our closing entries. So our first closing entry will be to debit service revenue in order to zero out that account. So we debit our service revenue and we are closing it to income summary, which means that we need to credit our income summary. And we get our amount by just taking the balance of our service revenue. So there we are closing our revenue to income summary. Once we make this journal entry, it is closed. Our revenue now has a zero balance, and that service revenue account is now closed. Now, we need to close our expenses to income summary. So we have four different expenses here, right? We have advertising expense, utilities expense, salaries, and rent. Expense accounts have normal debit balances. So in order to close our expenses, we're going to need to credit all of our expense accounts. So we credit our four expenses for their balance amounts. So advertising expense was 15,000, utilities was 20, salaries was 25, and rent expense was 10,000. Now, looking back at that flow chart that we had, we said that our expense accounts were all closed to income summary. So we'll debit our income summary here in this closing entry. Now, figuring out how much we debit income summary for here is a little bit trickier than in our first closing entry, right? We need to remember that our debits have to equal our credits. So what we're going to do is we're going to add up our four credits here. So your 15,000, 20,000, 25,000, and 10,000. We add up those four amounts and we get 70,000. So we will debit income summary for 70,000. Now remember that 70,000, all that is your total expenses. So we're debiting our income summary for the amount of our total expenses here in this closing entry. Now, our third closing entry is going to be to close income summary. And income summary, its balance isn't listed there in the upper left. So there's going to be another step in order to figure out that balance. And that's when we're going to want to make a T account. So if we make a T account for our income summary, we can see that income summary was first credited for 120,000 and then debited for 70,000. So we take our credits minus our debits over in our T account, and we see that income summary had a credit balance of 50,000. That's the information that we need in order to prepare a closing entry now to close income summary. And remember, whenever we want to make these closing entries, what we're trying to do is we're trying to zero out our accounts. So if income summary had a credit balance, to zero it out, we're going to need to debit our income summary. So we'll put income summary as our debit in this third closing entry. If we think back to that flowchart again, we saw that we closed income summary to owner's capital. So that means we'll credit our owner's capital here. And for how much? That's where that $50,000 comes into play. Because we need to debit income summary for $50,000 in order to zero out that account. Now, let's just take a look at what this journal entry is showing. That $50,000 is your net income. We found that $50,000 by taking 120 minus 70. 120,000, that was your revenue amount. 70,000, that was your expense amount. So revenues minus expenses give us our net income. So that 50,000 is your net income. If we think about owner's capital increases with a credit. On your owner's equity statement, net income is added on that statement. So we are increasing our capital by the amount of our net income, which is what you would do on your owner's equity statement. Now we have one final closing entry. We need to close our owner's drawings to owner's capital. Owner's drawings has a normal debit balance. So we close an account that has a normal debit balance by crediting that account. So we'll need to credit our owner's drawings. And then we think about where we close our owner's drawings to. And we close our owner's drawings to owner's capital. And we get the number here in this entry by looking at our owner's drawings balance. And that's where we get that 15,000. So you'll notice owner's capital is once again involved in this closing entry. But that $40,000 balance that's given in the upper left does not come into play in these entries. Because we never close owner's capital. We're closing things to owner's capital. Now, this last entry, if we break it down like we did our third one, we see that we are debiting owner's capital. Owner's capital decreases with a debit. And why does that make sense? Well, on an owner's equity statement, we subtract out our drawings. So you are decreasing your capital here by the amount of your owner's drawings, just like you would on an owner's equity statement. So your first, second, and fourth closing entry will always look similar. We'll always debit revenues, credit income summary. Debit income summary, credit expenses. And then in the last one, debit owner's capital, credit owner's drawings. That third closing entry that we have there, your accounts could be flipped. If you have a net loss instead of a net income, we would flip those two accounts, meaning you would debit owner's capital and credit income summary. So in that case, we would have had to credit our income summary in order to zero out that account. So that's why making that T account like we did can be really, really helpful while doing these closing entries. Just know that your first, second, and fourth closing entry will always have the similar framework. You might have different revenue accounts, you might have different expense accounts, but the idea is the same for all of those. Now, One last piece that you could be asked about with these closing entries is, what's your balance in owner's capital at the end of all of this? So let's make a T account for owner's capital. And this is where knowing that 40,000 initial balance matters to us, right? So we're going to start off with that 40,000. And that's our beginning balance in owner's capital. And now we want to post our closing entries into this T account. So we take a look at where our owner's capital is affected. And in our third closing entry, owner's capital is credited for $50,000. So we'll toss that $50,000 into our T account for owner's capital. Then, in our fourth closing entry, we see that owner's capital is debited for $15,000. So we'll put that over on the debit side. Now we can just figure out the balance based off of this T account. The way that we'll do that is we'll add up our two credits and subtract our debit. So 40,000 plus 50,000 minus the debit of 15,000 leaves us with an ending balance in owner's capital of $75,000.